Good evening, good morning, good afternoon to everybody. We are here at the Bitcoin Wednesday event in Amsterdam on the 6th of September, and we will have an interview with Ron Reichman from Snip. And Snip is a content distribution platform using blockchain technology and also using tokens to fuel the platform. Ron will provide a demo later this evening at the Bitcoin Wednesday. And looking forward to that, Ron. But now a sneak preview on what your company is all about and what your value proposition is. So maybe as a start, let's give a short introduction on your background, what you've done, how you come into this this space.
Sure. So I'm 30 years old from Israel. The last 10 years, I've been in the field of cybersecurity. In Israeli intelligence. I started with studying computer science, physics, and math. And then I worked 4 years as a coder, like hardcore software development. Yeah. Then 2 years as a team leader. I had like 9-10 software developers that I managed. And my final position was a program manager, which was leading a large hardware software project with about $10 million budget.
Okay.
And that was my last position. About a year and a half ago, I started Snip with my co-founder, Ronnie, or Ron and Ronnie.
So okay, it's a good deal.
Yeah, and he was also with me in the Army in intelligence.
Okay. Yeah.
And our goal was to create a new platform for news. We saw that the news industry is very much struggling, and that we think that we can build a new model using the blockchain, which is very much different, much more dynamic, more exciting, greater content for people. Yeah.
But now let's say the step from the intelligence service in the military towards CEO of a new content distribution platform is quite big. So how do you come to that that step?
So it wasn't necessarily a natural transition, even though many people after the military in Israel, they like to go to start technology companies.
Sure.
Both Ronnie and I are news junkies. We're like really passionate about news. And we were also very much interested in like starting a startup and building something new. And those things went very well together. We were both wanted to create something new and we're both leaving the military at the same time.
Yeah.
So it was a great opportunity to take this thing that we're passionate about, which is news, and bring in a lot of technology.
Okay, good stuff. So you're a company with you, yourself, and Ronnie. How many people are in Snip active, or what kind of ecosystem do you have around it?
So the company itself currently has three people. It's me, Ronnie, and a marketing lead, and Ophir. And the writers on the platform aren't Snip employees.
Yep.
They're like freelancers that are working on their own time. And we have several dozens of writers that are working worldwide, like Australia, UK, United States, whatever.
Yeah.
And we currently have about 30,000 users on our platform. Yeah, we've been gaining them pretty quickly. And last December, we started a subscription service. We wanted to see how valuable the Snip content is to people. Are they willing to pay for it?
Yeah.
And we reached more than 1,400 subscribers, paying subscribers.
Yeah.
So that was really exciting. We saw that like people are really engaged with the platform. They're commenting, they're sharing the content. So
okay. Maybe it's good to see what the platform is all about, right? What is your value proposition? What kind of problem would you like to solve?
Sure, definitely. So today there are the news industry is very fragmented. There are various websites, platforms, etc., and that creates it creates the wrong incentives many times in news. That's what brought us clickbait articles or inaccurate articles or sensational articles.
Uh-huh.
In addition to content which is simply too long. Many times there's a story which you could summarize in 4 or 5 paragraphs, but it's 1,000 words or 2,000 words, and it's very hard to actually read the story. And many people want to be informed about a topic. They want to know what's going on, but they don't necessarily have time to read everything there is to read about a subject.
Yeah. So is the value proposition that the news which is floating around on different communities already, for instance, Steemit community for content, or I myself use Feedly as a content aggregator, your value proposition that yet you have those content and freelance content providers, but you do it more condensed, more focused?
Yeah, we our writers, they take everything that's being told about a specific topic online and condense it into a very short story, like 2, 3, 4 paragraphs, where the goal is to answer the question, what's the deal with? People are always asking their friends, yeah, I heard about this, but what's the deal with that? What's going on there? Yeah. And we want to answer that question. We want to say, hey, if you're interested in this subject, we'll tell you what's going on there, and we'll keep you informed and interested.
Okay.
And our users are that's exactly the feedback that we're getting from our users. Yeah. They're saying, like, I know a lot more about interesting things because of Snip. I know what's going on. I'm informed. There are things that I care about that I know much more of.
So let's say the difference with Feedly, as far as I understand now, is that Feedly gets your profile, gets your interest, and get the first headlines of the news for you, but then redirect you to the content provider, right? Not curating the content, not doing anything with the content. So what you're saying is that you create the content, you get the content, and make a summary out of it, what's in it for me, in the 2-3 paragraphs.
Yeah, it's that's also the same difference between us and Reddit. Reddit is good at finding interesting content, but then you have to go back to the original story or one of the original stories. And we're trying to create a complete portrait of what is this story, what's happening there, and just give it to you in a personalized way.
Okay. That's a very interesting model. Now, of course, this field of content distribution is very competitive, right?
Yes.
So how do you look at, what is your differentiation beside the curating of the content? Your differentiation against the other content providers. Huh? What other examples can you mention which is unique for Snip?
So, first of all, the personalization is very important. Yeah. And because the content is short, we're able to provide you with much more personalized content. One of the reasons that Facebook is very good at giving you content that you actually care about is that they're able to collect a lot of data points. And we're also very good at that. You use our website for 5 minutes, we already know a lot about what you care about and what you don't. So that provides us with a big advantage. News sites, they're totally neutral. If you enter a news site and I enter a news site, they look exactly the same.
Yeah.
On Snip, everyone has their own experience. Okay. You enter the site and it's something different. Okay. And if you already read about something, then the site knows that you already know this topic and it doesn't show you it again.
Okay.
If you refresh, something new comes up.
Yeah. Yeah,
and that's also a great experience.
Okay, so what then is the combination of blockchain? And maybe after that, let's say, do you monetize? Do you use tokens? What is your plans on that domain? But first, go into the blockchain domain. How does that affect your solution?
So we started as a centralized service. Yeah. That we were just writing content and presenting it online. But we've been blockchain enthusiasts for quite a while, both Ronnie and me. And about half a year ago, we realized that the combination can be much more powerful. Because using blockchain, you can create incentive mechanisms that didn't exist before, really aligning the goals of both readers and writers on the platform, which is a huge problem in news. Because in news, many of the writers are just creating content. Yeah. But they don't know about the business part, and they don't know about the readers, and they're not
for free. Nobody wants to pay for it.
Yeah, nobody wants to pay. So we want to create this system where everything is really aligned, and blockchain is great for that. Because if writers are rewarded with a token, and readers can pay for services with a token, and advertisers are also using the same token to pay, then really the token is integral to the system. It's the heart of the system. Everything is flowing through this token, and the more users there are, the more the token is useful, and the more the platform can grow and thrive. Yeah.
So basically, the tokenization possibilities of blockchain is a trigger to move from, let's say, a central database towards a distributed database.
Yeah.
The tokenization, the monetization of your solution based on the blockchain technology.
Yeah, part of what we're doing, what I'm presenting today, is a demo of a tipping mechanism, where if you have a if you read an article and you really liked it, you can just tip with Snipcoin on the site. Uh-huh. Today's demonstration will be with Ethereum, but it's
sure.
Basically the same technology, and it's really simple. It's a really great way to show appreciation.
Yeah.
That also, it's something that doesn't exist online. I can read something great, and I don't have a mechanism to just click and tip. And people worry about the fees of the transactions, but we found that at this point they're still very much reasonable for tipping, because you don't need to do it real time.
Okay. Now, probably you've heard about Brave, right?
Sure.
And then Brendan Eich with his BAT token.
Yeah.
So that's a great development, I believe, right? Where, let's say, the user also has a possibility in the wallet, in the browser, to, let's say, to pay the content provider. And the user will be paid by the advertiser, right? So how do you fit into that model? If that model will be successful, there will be a Brave browser, and many people are using that. So there will be also the monetization element in the Brave browser to pay, let's say, the content providers. How would your model fit into that browser or that system, or is it totally separate?
So we're currently not integrated with BAT, with Brave, yep. with their systems,
okay.
Because we're in contact with them, but they're very much focused currently on development and not on partnerships,
sure.
And that's fine.
Yeah.
But we think that's great. We're really rooting for Brave.
Uh-huh.
And if that's successful, that'll also work excellently with Snip. Because
yeah.
if that becomes popular, then people will just will add support
exactly.
for additional tokens.
Yeah.
It'll be converted behind the scenes to Snipcoin.
Okay.
And that's fine. That's great. And we're aiming for as many partnerships in the field as possible, because it's not competitive.
Yeah.
The field is very competitive, but we're not competing with Brave in our view.
It's a kind of distribution channel for your content, right?
Yeah.
But the users will use the BAT token, the BAT token, but you will convert it into the Snipcoin for your content providers.
Yeah, exactly. And people will use the Brave browser, and if they're using the BAT token, that's awesome. Obviously, some people will still be using Chrome or Safari or whatever,
yeah.
and we'll also be supporting them.
Yeah.
So we're creating this ecosystem where you can access it anywhere you want.
Okay.
We're also publishing our content on IPFS so that it's totally distributed. So if you want your own browser, your own whatever, we're allowing that. We want the content. We're not telling you how to consume your content.
Sure. Okay. Well, that's a very interesting model. And now you exist now for 2 years.
Yeah, more or less.
So fully in development and doing marketing and having a paid service. What is your view for the next 1 or 2 year in terms of functionality you will add to your platform?
Oh, so it's actually really exciting.
It's stacked, right?
Yeah, because we're already getting great responses from our service, and the users, paid subscribers, is awesome.
Sure.
But first of all, the first order of business will be to insert the token into the system and start making transfers using the Snip token, and that's going to be early 2018. So that's just 3 months after the crowd sale, we're already expecting to insert the token into the system.
Okay.
Even before the crowd sale, we're adding an audio version of the news.
Uh-huh.
So you can have a personalized podcast of the news for you. We're using professional narrators for that.
Okay.
And adding much more content. Today, there's 2-3 articles a day. We're aiming for at least 10 times that.
Wow.
So that really cover everything that's
going
on. A broad
scope of topics. For the users. Now, you mentioned the term crowd sale for your token. I mean, not an ICO for your token.
Yes.
So ICO is a sensitive topic these days, right? We have heard about the Chinese regulator, about the SEC report in the US, that ICOs are in different shapes and forms. So when it's an asset or an investment vehicle, then of course it's a sensitive topic. But if it's a crowd sale, right, then of course it applies. How do you view that development in the term ICOs moving towards your token?
So that's a great question, and I don't think the wording is the main part. Like saying, it's good to say crowd sale and not ICO, but that doesn't change everything. You can't, like, if you're building a security, but you say crowd sale, you're still a security.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
So that doesn't solve the problem. Yeah. But we're very much focused on building a token which is useful on the Snip network. Like, we already have our platform, and the token is like an arcade token for the platform.
Yeah.
You can use it and pay for subscription services, or tip writers,
exactly.
or buy even advertising space on the platform. And the idea is that it's less useful, the token is less useful as a speculative mechanism, and we're also limiting the number of tokens you can buy. Because if you're buying like $1,000 of tokens, that makes sense. You could actually use them over time.
If
on the
you
Snip
read
network.
All day, a lot of context, yeah, if you're tip a lot.
If you're a big fan. Yeah. And over time, like, we're adding professional content. Like, if you're interested in AI, then there will be AI experts providing content.
Yeah.
So that could be a bit expensive.
Yeah, I understand. Yeah.
But if you're, so $1,000 could work. But like $50,000.
Yeah, then it's more an investment, right?
Yeah, that's probably more of an investment. So we're actually limiting also the scope of the investment. Of the not the investment, the purchase of tokens for it not to be an investment, for it, like, to attract actually the community and not speculators.
So about your business model, right? So the users will pay the content providers, but you will be the organization who orchestrates the content creation and distributing towards the users. What kind of financial model do you have? I mean, what sticks in, let's say, the Snip organization, and what goes to the content providers in terms of percentage, more or less? So if I pay a user one Snip coin, what part of that will remain at the Snip organization, and what will go to the content providers?
So we're there are two parts to that, like, to my answer. First of all, there's the crowd sale itself, and the goal is to have as many tokens as possible in the hands of the community. Like, our platform facilitates the creation of content, and we're aimed at creating a great platform where you can read this content and access this content. But someone could create a competing site and do it as well. Yeah. Like, we're not limiting that. So we're selling in this crowd sale 30% of the tokens, and leaving 30% for a future crowd sale, and another 20% is a fund for writers. So that'll also go to the community.
Okay.
The company will have less than 20% of the tokens, and also over time that will eventually, like, over time, expect the community to own almost everything.
Yeah.
So that's the crowd sale part. In the business part, initially we're planning to transfer 100% to the writers. Like, at the early stage, we're not planning on making a profit, but eventually, as the platform grows, we'll be taking a small cut of the transactions, and if the platform is successful, then that works. Like, a lot of writers, a lot of readers, a lot of advertisers, and we'll be taking a small cut of that.
Okay, so ambitious plans, right, for the future?
Oh yeah, for sure.
And with a team of three, with a large ecosystem around it, that's hard work. What I mean, are you doing marketing as well and promoting the platform? How do I see, as a consumer or a user, how can I access, let's say, the Snip service? I mean, what kind of marketing strategy do you have on it?
So obviously, we plan to hire more. We actually think that it's an advantage that we're a very small team, because burn rates can get very high.
Yeah.
Like, even if you raise $10 million, we're raising $8 million. Even if you raise like $10 million, if you have a team of 20 people, that ends pretty quickly. Yeah. Like, people need to get paid. So we're hiring slower than most teams, but we have this group of writers, which will be also ambassadors of Snip. Like, these are people who are writing for the platform, sharing it with their friends. And we also plan to use the token as a marketing tool, like rewarding people to share content with the token. Part of the company tokens will be used for that. Like, encouraging you, if you add a friend to the platform and they're using it, then you get tokens.
Okay.
And all these mechanisms, we'll also be using standard marketing, but we think standard marketing isn't enough. Like, you need paid advertising isn't enough. You need to actually engage people and make them tell their friends about your product.
Will you create a community also around Snip?
Yeah, that won't happen.
How will you do this?
So that won't happen on day one, but we're aiming to make the product over time more social, more interactive. You can share it with your friends. You can send it to, you can send content to other people, but we want it to be much more like a place where you can have discussions and interesting interactions.
Okay. And what's your future view on partnerships? I mean, are you potentially working on partners who can add value to your platform, or you can accelerate by signing partnerships? What's your view on that?
So we're very for partnerships, and we've already announced a partnership recently with AdX on advertising technology for our platform, because we want to really focus on building a platform for our users and not on things that other companies excel at. Like, we don't want to do everything. We want to focus on as little as possible.
Yeah.
And so AdX will be helping us with their advertising expertise. And we're also working on content partnerships, where a content creator create specific content for the Snip platform. Like, they take a very long story and create a snippet on our platform which links to that story.
Exactly, yeah.
And they'll be rewarded for that.
Okay.
And we think that'll happen more and more over time.
Okay. Well, it's a very, very interesting roadmap and a very exciting world we're living, right? On the content distribution, using blockchain, using tokens. So as a closing, and we come to a close of the interview, do you have any closing remarks in terms of your future view of your company and the landscape you're working in?
Sure. So, what I would mainly like to say is that news is such an exciting place. Like, information and what's going on in the world, there's so much going on there, and there's so, like, we're really excited about this opportunity because we see how people value high quality content, and we're just like really excited to create more and more of that and like bring that to the users.
It's very nice to pursue your dream, right? After military service, go into the content distribution and push forward the content across the world.
Yeah.
So thanks very much for the interview.
Thank you, it was great.
And good luck with your company, and good luck with the demo this evening as well.
Thank you very much.
Okay.